Spoiler alert, anime isn't real. I'll give you a minute to absorb that. Okay, we know it isn't real, so let me ask this. How fake can it get? We know that teenage ninjas in orange jumpsuits don't exist, but they still obey the laws of gravity in Naruto and Boruto. Okay, technically only when they're not doing crazy stunts. Still, you know what I mean. In Naruto, what jumps up must eventually fall down. But there's another layer. Since anime isn't showing you what's actually happening, does it have to visually represent that accurately at all times? If a character's holding a gun, but the gun isn't loading and it's as effective as a banana to that character, could you actually show the character holding a banana instead of a gun because that's what it symbolizes? It's at this point in these sorts of philosophical discussions where people start having strong reactions, and it's typically a very common division in the appreciation of art. Some people want art to be representational, with symbolism limited to real objects with multiple meanings, like a dove representing both peace and domestication. Others are comfortable with wildly symbolic art, where the visuals don't have to directly represent anything. Night is Short, Walk On Girl consistently jumps back and forth on either side of that division. It uses abstraction and visual symbolism. What you see on screen may not be what's actually happening. Now, this is a movie about a young woman and a young man during one crazy night in modern-day Kyoto, and right away the filmmakers tell you that they're not going to be perfectly representational. Look at this opening shot and how the girl gulps down her drink. As the story develops and the plot threads get crazier, you have to ask yourself if the characters are really experiencing what you see on the screen. Is this guy really competing with monsters in a spicy noodle eating contest? Well, no, because the characters aren't really experiencing anything in the movie. It's all made up. Now, the danger in this lies in leaning so far into abstraction that everything feels random. Unfortunately, the movie staff avoids that trap. The unrealistic sequences still drive the story forward because they contain symbols for what's going on. Both realistic and unrealistic elements weave together into one thematically consistent narrative. The unrealistic parts aren't random, they're purposeful, they're just not perfectly real. And none of it's real. To me, it's that abstract realism that elevates Night is Short, Walk On Girl from charming shoujo story, and there's nothing wrong with that, into thought-provoking capital A art. Now, some folks still dislike that, and that's okay. Art doesn't have to be universally liked. But still, I think if you see what it's trying to go for, you can appreciate what it actually accomplishes. And I think what it accomplishes really is art.